Hi students, in today's lecture we will be looking at how to generate delay using a timer. We will be looking at timer 0, which you can easily use it for the same steps can be used for timer 1. Now we will look at first the register of timer 0. So already we have seen the T0 con register over here. Now in this register, what you can see is we need to select which mode we are going to work in. So first is 8 bit or 16 bit. So whether I want to use an 8 bit timer or a 16 bit timer, that is selected by 80 bit, T0 8 bit. The second is what clock source are we going to use in, that is whether I am using the internal F oscillator or an external clock is being used. So that can be selected by the T0 CS. And if I'm using an external clock, what kind of edge triggering it will be there, we will see when we are using the timer as a counter. Now, whether I want to use a prescaler or not. So we have seen how the prescaler divides your clock, internal clock again, so that we get a lower frequency clocks. So we will see how we can use this in our program. And finally, the MSB, the TMR0 on will start or stop the timer, right? So let us start with an example and let us start doing the calculations. Now here we can see that I am doing a 50 millisecond delay. I'm using a 50 millisecond. I want to generate a 50 millisecond delay, right? Now for our ease of calculation, what we'll do is first we'll use a 16 bit mode. Okay. So to get to the 16 bit mode, what we need to do is we have to make this T0 8 bit as 0. Okay. So let us jump back to our calculation, right? Now we are using, my board has an oscillator of 4 megahertz. So here you can see it is 4 megahertz that will be divided and I will get around 1 megahertz clock, right? So 1 megahertz clock, 4 megahertz divided by 4 internally, we will get 1 megahertz. That is equivalent to 1 microsecond, right? Now that means for every one count, so if the count increases by 1, you have a delay of 1 microsecond. So for 50 millisecond, that is 50 into 10 raised to 3 microsecond. So I will say 50,000, right? And I will divide. So I will require around divided by this 1 microsecond. So if I get one count for 1 microsecond, so for 50,000 microsecond, what is the count? It's a very simple mathematics. It's just 50,000 counts. I have to go for 50,000 counts, right? Now in this case, we need to count 50,000. Now the problem is when I complete start, let us say I start from 0 and start counting till 50,000, 0, 1, 2, 3, and it reaches 50,000. There is no indication to say that we have reached 50,000, right? Now the problem is we do not know when we have reached 50,000. Now that is the issue with the timer. Now we can solve this problem because we have this bit called as the TMR0IF. Okay. So this is the overflow flag. Right. Overflow flag. Now if we see the number, this is cannot be fit in a 8 bit. So let us say we have the overflow flag over here. So that acts as an indicator saying that something has happened. Right. Now let us look at this number 50,000. This cannot be, this is greater than 255. So I cannot use the 8 bit mode. I have to go to use the 16 bit mode. So in the 16 bit mode, I can have maximum 65,535. And if I count the overflow flag, so that is an overflow, I will have to count 1. So this becomes 65,536. So the 16 bit timer, 16 bit plus the TMR0IF also adds the 1 count to give you 65,536 counts. And this is when this flag will be set, when you get this number 65,536. Now the problem that we have over here is that when we reach 50,000, we don't get an indication. But this can be solved by something called as a reload value. Now instead of starting from 0, if I start from 65,536 minus 50,000, that is around 15,536. Now if I start counting from 15,536 and end at 65,536. That means the difference between this is again 50,000, and I can get also an indication because TMR0IF in this case becomes 1. So I know that 50 millisecond has passed, right? So in this way, timer can be operated using a reload value, right? So we can have a reload value over here in this case, right? Now, let us look at if I want to operate in the 8-bit mode. Now, in the 8-bit mode, the same thing applies. Everything is the same. 1 megahertz, we have 1 megahertz, that is 4 megahertz divided by 4 equal to 1 megahertz equal to 1 microsecond. And say I want 50 millisecond, that is 50,000 microsecond. I want to count 50,000 microsecond and I want to do it in the 8-bit mode. This is just to show how prescaling works, right? Now, if I see 8-bit mode, the maximum I can do is 255 plus 1, that is your TMR0IF flag, okay, this flag. So here you can have 256 microsecond delay, but what I want is a 50 millisecond delay, right, using the same 8-bit mode or using the 8-bit mode, right? So what we can do, what we do is, we have the F oscillator. I will use this clock so that I will use this prescaler, right? So using this PSA bit, I will choose the prescaler and I will choose. So here, let us say we want 50,000, right? So how do you choose which prescaler to go for, right? So one method is you either go for the highest one or you can directly say 50,000 divided by 256, that comes around to 198, something like that. That means this is the multiplication count that you require. So it is generally the last. So this is the one that we need to go for, right? So if I divide my 50,000 microsecond by 256 microsecond, you may have this number, nearly approximate to this number. So you see, I have to multiply by 198 times 256 microseconds, then only I will be able to get a 50 millisecond delay. Okay, so here what I will do is I can have to divide it by 256, right? So I will using the prescaler of divided by 256. That means my 1 megahertz clock is again divided by 256. So the final frequency is 1 megahertz divided by 256. That is somewhere around 3906 kilohertz. That is equivalent to 0.25 millisecond. So this is equivalent to 0.25 millisecond. Okay. Now in this case, this is 0.25 millisecond, right? So if I want 50 millisecond, same way, 50 millisecond divided by 0.25 millisecond. So that is 5000 divided by 25. That is 200, right? So I want a count of 200. So if I count 200 times, right? So what has happened? Let us again calculate it. I am using a prescaler of 1:256. So the 1 megahertz clock is again divided by 256. We will end up with 3906 kilohertz. That if I consider into time, that is 1 upon F, I'll get 0.25, approximately 0.25 millisecond, right? So for each count, I'll get 0.25 millisecond delay. So if I want 50 millisecond delay, how much count is 50 millisecond divided by 0.25 millisecond. That is around 5000 by 25 and that is around 200. Okay. Now this value is the 200 value. Again, I have to calculate the reload. Now the reload over here is 256. Okay. I have to subtract by 256 by 200. And 56 is your reload value, right? So this value I need to TMR0. So instead of starting from 0 and counting till 200, I will start at 56 and I will count till 256. Both will give me 200 counts. But the reason over here we count this way is because this TMR0IF indicator will give you the indication, okay? Or this flag will give you the indication that something has happened or the delay has, whatever delay we have set has been completed. Okay. Now let us look at what are all the steps for configuring the timers. First, find out your delay, right? What is the delay? So first delay, check and calculate your delay. Now find out whether you have to use a 16-bit mode or 8-bit mode, which will work. Depending upon the delay, whether I want to use a prescaler or not. Right? Now in this case of timer, we generally use the internal clock. So use the select your internal clock or F oscillator by 4 generally. After that, after selecting the internal clock, now before doing all of this, we need to ensure the timer is switched off. So somewhere over here, you need to ensure the timer is switched off using the timer off bit. So timer off register is off. Now after selecting the internal clock, F oscillator by 4, clear your overflow flag. That is TMR0IF. Then what you need to do is put the reload value into TMR0H and TMR0L, depending upon whether you are using a 16-bit mode or a 8-bit mode. Okay, then what you need to do is start the timer. Now in the main program, in the loop, what you need to do for the delay is check for overflow. So this is configuring, and for the main program you have to check the overflow flag, and the moment it becomes set, if set, then what you need to do is again reload the value. Okay, because your counting should start from the reload value and not from zero, right? So again reload the value. Again reload the value into TMR0H and TMR0L. Clear your overflow flag. Okay, and we need to ensure that we need to clear your overflow flag, right? So this is how you have to configure the timers. Now let us see the C program of how to write this in a embedded C program for configuring the timers.